There's a lighthouse on the hillside that overlooks life's sea. When I'm tossed, it sends out a light that I might see, and the light that shines in darkness now will safely lead us home. If it was for the lighthouse, my ship would be no more.
And I thank God for the lighthouse. I owe my life to Him.
Everybody that lives around us, they say tear that old lighthouse down. The big ships, they don't sail this way anymore. There's no use of it standing round. Then my mind goes back to that stormy
is the lighthouse, and from the rocks of sin He has shone His light around me, that I could clearly see if it wasn't for the
gentlemen, thank the Lord for that lighthouse. Jesus is the lighthouse. Hey, you know what? All this week, we've been talking about how to read your Bible. Monday, we talked about reading it confidently and reading it thoughtfully. By the way, our theme verse is this. It's found in 1 Timothy chapter number 4, verse 13, where Paul wrote to young Timothy and said, "Till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine." He said, show up, attend, show up at reading the Bible, show up for exhortation, hearing the Word of God taught and preached, and to doctrine, that is, trying to learn exactly what the Bible's saying and make that personal application so that you can make that personal application in your life. On Monday, read the Bible confidently and read the Bible thoughtfully. On Tuesday, we talked about read the Bible consistently and read the Bible thoroughly. And Wednesday, we mentioned this, read the Bible unselfishly and read the Bible discriminately. And all those things I've explained more fully on each one of those days. And so if you'd like to go back and read those, they should be right there in the timeline. Just scroll down a little farther, or go to Lonnie Mattingly on YouTube, or Brother Lonnie on YouTube, and you'll find it there. And that can be a help to you as well. Well, today we're going to do number 7 and number 8, and then tomorrow we'll do 9 and 10. And hopefully you'll have your guns loaded, and you'll be ready to read the Bible successfully and consistently and thoroughly and thoughtfully and all those things. And today, number 7, read the Bible intelligently. In other words, turn your brain on before you start reading. Don't just read it at your, I can't hardly keep my eyes open. I'm going to sit here. I'm going to read a few verses and fall asleep. That's not intelligent. You probably won't even remember what you read. But in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 16 and 17, the Bible says this: all scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. So the Bible, we need to read it intelligently. It's given for inspiration. God wants to inspire us. God wants to help us to have some insight and have some profit from the reading of the Word of God, and to be able to be blessed and to be encouraged, and to be taught good, sound doctrine. And he said, for reproof, when you find something's wrong, it'll straighten you out. And for correction, same idea, thought there. And for instruction, listen to this one. Here's what a lot of people don't like. They don't want anybody telling them what to do, not even God. But it's for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. So every man that's watching or listening today, if you're saved, you're a man of God. You may not be a pastor of a church or a prophet or a priest or an evangelist, but you're God's man. You're God's man. You're a man of God. You're a child of God, but you're God's man. And God wants you to be furnished, thoroughly furnished. He wants you to have everything you need to carry out his will, and you get it from the Word of God. So when you read your Bible, I would have a little notebook there that you could jot down something God says, put the reference there. I would also maybe underline some verses in the Bible, maybe even try to write a little note in the margin, or put a red star by something, whatever you need to do to make sure that you're going to hang on to some of this stuff. I've got to be intelligent about this thing. If I'm going to learn it, I got to burn it into my brain. If I learn it, burn it, get it in your brain and keep it there. Well, that's that one. That's read the Bible intelligently. And then number 8, and this is the last one today, read the Bible hopefully. We got a lot of hopeless people in this world today. Now, I don't mean that they're without hope. It means that's the way they feel about themselves. Well, it's just hopeless. I'm in a hopeless situation, a hopeless marriage. My kids are hopeless. Something's hopeless. You know, they just are ready to throw in the towel, giving up. But listen what the Bible says, Psalm 119, verses 114 through 116. He said, here's the psalmist, and he's writing to God, being inspired of God to write this for our benefit. He said, thou art my hiding place and my shield. I hope in thy word. Say, preacher, sometimes I'm just without hope. I don't think there's any chance that this thing's going to work out, or whatever it is. But I want to tell you something. If it's not going to work out, it may not be God's will. So maybe you pray about it a little bit also. But if it is God's will, God will help you get there if you'll keep your hope, keep believing him, and live by the promises of the Word of God. He said, God, you're my hiding place. You're my shield. And David, this was a time in his life where there were some people trying to destroy him. And he said, I hope in that word, your word is going to be my defense. Your word's going to be my protection. He said, depart from me, ye evildoers, for I will keep the commandments of my God. Uphold me according to thy word, that I may live, and let me not be ashamed of my hope. He said, I have my hope in Almighty God, and I'm hoping in the Word of God, and the Word of God is my shield and my hiding place. So you evildoers, you just might as well give up. Get out of my life. Stay away from me. I will keep the commandments of my God. Isn't that great? Listen to the one more verse, Psalm 119, verse 147. He said, I prevented the dawning of the morning. I cried, I hoped in thy word. Think of that. What you said, preacher, what's he saying there? I prevented the dawning of the morning. He stopped the morning from, no. He got up before the sun did. He was ahead of the sun. He preceded it. He prevented it. He was there first. He was already up, already walking with God, already depending on the word, already perhaps had opened his Bible as he had it and read some of the word of God to get some strength and some wisdom for that day. I prevented the dawning of the morning and cried, I hoped in thy word. He cried out. He said, I found something in here. Maybe he rejoiced. Maybe it was a cry of rejoicing. Well, hallelujah, look what God showed me. Or maybe it just filled his eyes with tears to know that there was a loving God watching over him as he read the word of God and hoped in it. And what a thing. So don't just read don't just read the Bible for information. Read it for inspiration, for hope, for answers that help in your life. Read the Bible with expectation. Believe that God is going to give you what you need for that day, and then go about that day trusting God. When something even seems to go wrong, you say, okay, the Lord's allowing this to happen for a reason, so I'm going to keep on hoping in him. I'm going to keep on trusting him. I'm going to keep on going back to the Word of God again and again. Heavenly Father, thank you for the precious Word. Thank you, Lord, for the folks that tune in to Mid-Morning Manna on a regular basis. I pray you'll bless them. And maybe if there's some newcomers there today, you'll bless them as well. And Father, we give you the praise, and we love you, and we love your word. And I pray that you'd help us to hope in that word. And we give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen.